Not ill. Well, let's get back to Celeste. When I left off, I was climbing the mountain. And I still am. So there's that. Thanks for the luck, Corn Cob. Mirror Temple. Did you know most climbing mishaps occur due to exhaustion? Remember to take regular breaks. I did remember. Oh man, look at this place. Feeling adventurous? I don't know. It looks pretty dark in there. More like a nightmare than an adventure. I'll just take a quick peek, snap a few photos. This place must be ancient. Theo, wait. My Instapix followers are gonna eat this up. There's no way this ends well. Nice lighting. You can see, like, crawling around the corners and whatnot. Do I feel like my Lama Lana platforming skills have translated into this? I mean, I wouldn't necessarily tie it into Lama Lana, because Lama Lana wasn't exactly my first platformer, you know? But yeah, skills have crossover. I wouldn't say Lama Lana and this game have a lot in common as far as the platforming, because this game has like Lama Lana, the platforming is, I would say, a fair bit more deliberate, whereas this game has like a lot more fluidity. There's still like a fair amount of momentum in the air. So it would be closer to Lama Lana 2 if I was going to pick between, you know, the Lama Lana remake and Lama Lana 2. But yeah, there's gonna be like some amount of crossover of skill set. Also, I'm not sure that Lama Lana really had particularly difficult platforming. Even in Hell Temple, it's not that it's not that bad. Come on. This is Theo's phone. Don't panic, Madeline. Maybe it just fell out of his pocket. I'll give it back to him when I find him. Okay, so there's that. And looks like that's the only thing that I can see here. Hey, Balance Maker. Okay. So I guess the red spheres go for a lot longer, and then there's some buttons. I wonder if you have to hit those with the spheres, or if you can just hit them with anything else. You can already see the broken wall up there. Interesting. Not intended. Shit. Although kind of interesting, because you can do this. Okay. There seems to be several ways that you can go here. So I guess I'll start going. Okay. No, the bubbles, like, self-activate. Like, I have a limited amount of time in the bubble, and then it just goes in the direction that I'm pressing, or a direction. Okay. Well, I can certainly bounce off of this thing, but then if I dash to get it on the other side, then it's not going to go super well for me. And I don't think I can make it all the way over there, just on the bounce. And the problem there is that I would need to land on that. That would bounce me up, and then I could go down and get the strawberry, but by the time I've gotten the strawberry and I'm able to kick off of the wall, I think this thing will have gone to the other side. Of course, at that point in time, I will have already bounced off of it, and then I can recharge my thing, so it should work out just fine. Alright. Derp. So there seems to be a couple of different ways into this room. If I can dash down into one of these things, then I can capitalize on the extra momentum and use that to jump across. But I think that's what I'm going to be looking at. There it is. I did the thing. Can't see a way that I would use to get back up here. So maybe I'll explore a little bit more. There are also chambers up above, too. Okay. Damn. Whoop. What am I doing? That's interesting as well. Because this room has definitely taught me, like, a different use of the dash mechanic. Ah! I thought I had that. The game, like, lagged for a second. Damn it! Yeah, so I guess I can use the dash on the ground to gain, like, a tremendous amount of momentum, which is pretty cool. Once I'm up here, I can grab that, but then I guess I need to have the dash to get back. That would help me get up there. Oops. Fast. Yep, I thought I still had the charge. Wiggling in the background right here. Oops. There's like a mirror down here. Oh, actually, I wonder if I've... I was like, I don't want to necessarily start the next plot segment or whatever. What did that do? Dang it. Of course. Okay. I wasn't sure if Madeline's other thingy was gonna be doing stuff. So I feel like the one on the right isn't terribly complicated. All I really have to do is this. Only, you know, not screwed up. One on the left, though? I mean, it's going to be something similar. Oh, right. Creepy eye. Is there another way over here? There was. Oh, this was the dark room. Don't think I'm ready to go in there just yet. There's more things to do. This is dangerous. Okay. This one comes down and then refreshes and then... yeah. Quite work out the way I wanted it to. I suppose I could fall off the bottom and then... do something like that. I guess that works. Colon backslash. Thanks for the luck. Okay, so... we can grab onto the back end of that one. So I think what I want to be doing is that, but better. Much better. So, it doesn't matter. Yeah. Hit that. I can go off the wall. Diagonally up. Go over there. And then... yeah. Game! Damn it! Yeah, the grace period inside these bubbles is not very long. Need to jump off. I can't just move over. Sometimes I feel like I carry momentum in a weird way, or in a way that I'm not fully expecting it, and then like that. Like, I released the controls because I thought, hey, okay, well, when I impact with the ceiling, I'll just kind of stop moving, but Celeste doesn't. So it's like requiring more inputs, particularly the time when, like, I'm... like, you're hitting the object with, like, this... I mean, it's not a huge particle effect or something like that, but it does make Celeste disappear for like a fraction of a second. And when that fraction of a second matters, it can kind of screw me up a bit. Never played this, but from watching it, you despise the spike hitboxes. Everything else looks really cool. Alright, well. Guess we're gonna go this way now. It's Theo. Or not. Madeline, hey. Why are you inside a mirror? I'm pretty sure you're the one in the mirror. What happened? Well, I was taking a nonchalant mirror selfie. You know, it's your boy Theo in this ancient temple, no big deal. Hashtag blessed. Next thing I know, I wake up lying on the ground. What does it look like over there? How can I find you? It's, really dark and weird. There's... wait, something's coming. I'm feeling a strong inclination to run away. Be careful, okay? What is that in there? It's a thing! Oh. It just opens that. Well, I'm not interested in that. I'm interested in what's up here. I wonder if these runes on the wall mean anything, or if they're just... decorative. No, okay. This is simple enough. in practice. Oops. Simple enough in principle, perhaps, Elfren. Tried and true, rub your face on every wall approach to exploration. I'm not really a huge fan of that type of gameplay. I think I'm more so just using it in here to make sure that, like, I have some sense of what the environment looks like. I mean, yeah, you know, to a certain extent there's going to be possibly secrets in the walls or something like that, but I don't know what the environment looks like, then I'm gonna be kind of in trouble. Lamalana approach? Hell, if you watch my Lamalana 2 playthrough, you would have seen that. But I didn't do a hell of a lot of that in Lamalana. It was one of the things that I really liked about the game. There are places where it winds up becoming, like, a part of the gameplay, and those are definitely parts of it that I'm less a fan of, but I like the fact that that sort of information is presented to the player differently. Okay. Whoa. Okay, so I've got some kind of door unlock in here. Somewhere. Look at every wall in case there's a secret button. Oof. Part of the problem with Grimrock secret buttons, which I think I talked about when I was playing that game, is that they're not really secrets. Because if you know what... Like, there's... I think in the first game there were two styles of secret button, or like two areas on a wall in which a secret button could exist. At which point, you're not even looking for secret buttons, you're just looking for buttons. Okay, so I need to do this without dashing. That was a mistake. I think I'll just keep going up. That's been working for me so far. Ooh. Not quite. I disagree. still doesn't resolve this issue. Although there was another thing in the ceiling up here, so maybe it's just that. It is indeed just that. I also like the... not just in terms of the soundtrack in this particular area being chill, but it seems to really suit the environment. I remember in some of the other areas, you know, notably where, like, the wind was blowing, there was, like, a little bit more of a... swell of the music, something that was a bit more, you know... action-y or something. Okay, so I can dash and grab onto that, and then I'll just need to let go of it before the other one comes back. Okay, and here I'm not really going to be interacting with that at all. I just need to climb quickly, I think. Okay, then. So there's this way. Was there another way that I could go? Yeah, there's something down here, I think. This one, and then I think that was it. Not quite. I almost wonder if there's something else down there? You know, up there, but... I mean, probably not. So if I grab onto the side here, it's only going to drag me so far, which will not be helpful. Unless there's something maybe in the middle up there? Let's have a look around. There is indeed. Oops. Exactly. Got another key here. Another weird-ass looking thing. I mean, they kind of glow in the dark, so any place where they're not is probably somewhere I can go. At least a little bit. Careful about climbing, I'm gonna run out of stamina in that middle, which is probably why that spike is there, to prevent me from just doing an easy job of... I wasn't paying enough attention to the right side of the screen when I came through below. So I'm not entirely sure what's below me. That's alright. Through there. That seems very plain. Down below, I suppose. Creepy. There's something about these thorns in the background that make me very wary. Like, if I'm going to touch those, then very bad things will happen. I can't quite seem to shake the sense of it. I've been using these lights a lot in this area to guide the player, which I don't know. It's almost kind of weird in some ways. Maybe it's not. I guess I just can't stop thinking about it in the context of, like, I feel as though, like, the level at which the player is at this point in time is probably beyond needing those kinds of guides. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Hello. I wanted to do more lighting up of things, though. There we go. What's down here? Not death. Not death is down here. So getting to the middle and getting the strawberry seems fairly easy. The question is, how do I get back? Because if I go on a diagonal, I'll likely impact with, like, one of these two corners, at which point I can fall. I can then grab that. Oh no, yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Thinking about it the wrong way, I think. I was thinking, like, man, once I use the dash, I'll be stuck in the middle. It's like, right, you just don't use the dash, and you can easily jump over that. Point where I failed. Okay. Well, I did want to check up here. Haha! Hey, well, didn't get to watch the end of the last stream, but were there bears? No. No, I'm not sure that there are bears in this game. I think I was just spurred on by the idea that the game has Canadian postcards, takes place on top of a snowy mountain. It's reminding me a little bit of The Long Dark. Yeah, Boix knows what's up. You know, you're wandering around in some idyllic stream, and you're just minding your own business, and then, hey, there's a bear behind you. Hey, Boix. How you doing? Okay. Count it. Thing. What up? It's the B-side. Okay. So I guess I'll shoot through here when the purple is about to run out. I might still impact with this blue one, but then I should be able to dash the rest of the way onto this platform. The rest of the room is... Yeah. I mean, it's straightforward if... if not easy. Another part of me thinking about streaming The Long Dark again has a little bit to do with... This was just this room, right? The fact that... I mean, the first couple of episodes are actually quite different than they were when they were initially released. There is actually this whole segment where Mackenzie has to fight, you know, the old bear. And you wind up having to use one of the goddamn, like, bear spears. And it's, it's something. It might be worthwhile showing off. Okay, so I don't want to get crushed. So I need to do this. But then... I guess there has to be, like, another little slot that I can get into so that I avoid getting mega crushed here. Yeah, like that. And then... I really need some momentum, so... That was not the momentum I was looking for. You know? Not even close. That's a little more like it. Come here, you. Alright. Is the spooky Halloween event still in the game? They took it out, but I think... I don't know. Like, they put so much work into it, and it was quite well received, that it is now just a permanent part of the challenge modes that are available in the game. So yeah, it's still in there. Which I'm glad. Did I do all the things? I think I did all the things. Let's mosey on over to this room. Is this death? That's not death, but that is. That is definitely death down below. Okay, we've got spikes and other fun things. I guess I'm taking a one-way trip here. Well, perhaps not. Going up? The Long Dark could probably benefit from a Left 4 Dead style enemy generator. I'm sure you mean that in a different way than the images that my brain came up with. Bear smoker. Oh my god. A bear that can reel you in. I needed to sleep later tonight, Boix. What are you doing? An AI director would be nice, though. Yeah, it could be an interesting idea. Because I think there are... Like, there's many times where... Well... I mean, I'll take a moment here and say, like, sometimes I feel a bit mixed with AI directors and the kind of experience they wind up producing. Because... I mean, I like the whole... It's basically EA catch-up logic in a racing game applied to a first-person shooter. Which is like, oh man, the race isn't exciting unless they're, like, right on your tail. We gotta help out the AI to make them catch up. And then, you know, when you're not doing so great, we'll make them slow down so that it seems like you've got a winning chance. Because it's not fun if you don't, you know... If you're not, like, right in that sweet spot. Which, frankly, I disagree. I mean, if I'm playing really well and optimally and I'm totally crushing a game at it, that doesn't bother me. But sometimes you get into those situations where the AI director just absolutely dumps on you. And I've had that happen to my and also the group of buddies. Like, we played Vermintide and Vermintide 2. And yeah, like, there's sometimes where the game just spawns everything on you because you're doing really well, and it causes like an instant party wipe because it's like, okay, like, what were we supposed to have done against that? And like, I've beaten Vermintide 2 on like all the levels on, what is it, the highest difficulty in the base game. I don't have the DLC for like the over or whatever. You know, the crazy difficulty. But like, I beat Skittergate on Legend. So I don't suck at it by any stretch of the imagination. But holy smokes, man. When the AI director wants to be mean, then it just, it will be. Oh shit. And I think sometimes that can lead to really unfun play. Ah, fuck. Timing left a little bit to desire there. Although, interestingly, this area is not particularly spooky, in my opinion. I mean, it's dark and whatnot, but I think the music gives it more of, like, a abandoned, creepy atmosphere? Not creepy. Mysterious. We'll go with that. Although some of these things in the background, some of these statues could like straight up come like out of a game like La Milana. Going up. Oh dear. This doesn't look like a boss room at all. Donkey Kong Country of Water. I never played any of the Donkey Kong games apart from like the OG arcade titles. Dun dun dun. Hit me. Omnop. This is death, right? Okay, no. It's just not a place I can go. Are these things death? Those things are death. I wasn't sure if they were like the waggly things that were on walls before. Hey! Where are we? What did you do to Theo? You think I'm doing this? That's cute. Sweetheart, this is exactly what I warned you about. Don't try to make this my fault. You still don't get it. The mountain gave me this body. But I'm not the only creepy thing living in that messed up head of yours. Don't like what you see? What a surprise. Shut up. I tried to stop you. Look into the mirror. All of this is yours. This temple only magnifies the mountain's power. You're in control here, not me. I don't believe you. If you're part of me, why do you want to hurt me? Poor Madeline. Always the victim. All I do is babysit you, and you hate me for it. You are unraveling, and you know it. If you care so much about protecting me, why didn't you just explain what was going on? Like you would have listened. You never gave me a chance. Please, just help me get out of here. Now you want me to save you. Why are you doing this? Just be on my side here. Please. Stop trying to make me feel like a monster. You really want to know why I won't help? Because you deserve this. Still think you can climb this mountain? Shut up! I don't need your help. I'll do this alone. Bonk! See you, nerd. Okay. So I can go in here, but they can't. Bonk. Thanks for the help, sucker. Any way to teach the mechanics of the enemies beforehand? Yeah, it's interesting. It's different. Remember that time I said this level wasn't so creepy? I mean, it's more creepy now. It's not that bad, though. I mean, at least for me. If this is all in my head, why is it so hostile? Why indeed, Madeline? Those things are hunting me. I'm a trespasser in my own world. Theo is trapped somewhere in here because of me. If I give in fully, maybe the temple will let him go. Breathe. This is all coming from inside me. Get up, Madeline. Think of the feather. You can save Theo. Somehow I don't think that Theo is currently experiencing this nightmare. There's like this glowing spine thing in the background. Okay. Nope. Totally blanked. Didn't see those. Should have, because they're like right there. But whatever. Don't think I'm getting through there, even if I use this. Oh, we can go down here. Oh. Okay, this opens this up. And we can go down a bit more. Let's do some more exploring in here, though.
So I need to dash into the bubble
so that I can get onto the other side of it. And then... yeah, this'll be fine. Or something. Not quick enough. Derp. One. Eo, thank God I found you. Madeline, well, am I happy to see you. Are you alright? Yeah, I'm fine. I've just been stuck in this crystal thing for ages. Do you get the feeling this place knows you better than you know yourself? Yeah. I'm so embarrassed that you have to see the side of me. I tried to stop you. I hope that selfie was worth it. Selfies are always worth it, dude. I shouldn't be mad. This isn't your fault. I'm glad you're safe, but you're trapped because of me. And now this temple is showing you what I'm really like. I'm horrible. Hey, we're in this together. Don't act like this is all on you. What do you mean? You didn't trap me in this crystal. Sure, those monsters are coming from you, but the temple is shaping itself around me too. I can feel it. These eyes are staring at me. And this crystal is coming from me. I know it. I hate to ask, but I really need your help right now. Okay, I've got your back. I'll bust you out of that thing, and then we'll escape together. Just as soon as I find my way around you. Madeline, you're my only hope right now. I believe in you. For real. I hope that's not a mistake. What up, nerd? Well, I can still make this. It's fine. Okay, we have another key, I guess. Wait a minute, what? I guess. Thank you.
not quite.
A little better. Sure. I was thinking, like, if I dash through that now, does anything special happen? Guess not. There's another way to the right. Can I just go through here? Hmm. Okay. That's fine, I'll just go in through the room again. Or perhaps I won't. Going. Jeez. There's definitely been some avenues that have been cut off. I wonder if I need to drag this guy in. Perhaps not. I already had this conversation. I retract my earlier compliment about this game not the skipping dialogue. This is literally the same cutscene. Compliment revoked. Okay. So... oh. Yeah. There we go. Alright. I'm gonna jump on your head, stupid jerk. Obsession with lighting these damn things. Theo, I finally found you. I knew you'd make it. It wasn't easy. Are those monsters really coming from inside me? Madeline, that's a valid question. I'll be happy to discuss how the monsters relate to your inner self. But right now, my inner self is real sick of being stuck in this crystal. Oh, right. Don't worry, I'll break you out. Well, this is a solid start, but the crystal is like an expression of my negative psychic energy, or whatever. Yeah, but how do we break it? If I knew why I trapped myself in this thing, maybe I could bust out. But I don't. And I don't think I can get to the bottom of it while we're stuck in this nightmare dimension. I hate to say it, but you might have to... Theo, don't even think about that. I am not leaving you behind. Hell no! You better not leave me in this place. I was gonna say you might have to carry me. Oh. Yeah, I can do that. Dang, girl! You can lift! I know how to deal with these things. Throw Theo at them. Oh, dang it. I wanted to dash down into it. Get out of here. Okay, I'm gonna move him as close to the door as I can. And then, I guess... Wait. Is there nothing up here? What is this thing for? I'm so confused. God damn it. Stupid monster. Get out of here. Yeah, maybe it's nothing. Thanks for the lift, buddy. Whoops. I didn't think I was gonna throw him that far, but, you know, hey, what can you do? Yes, you are, Theo. Good job. Ah! Jerk. Bouncing and throwing Theo is a little bit janky. Not tremendously, but, you know, a little bit. Oh, god damn it. Also, the charge seems to be, I guess, like, somewhat variable depending on, like, how close to the monster's, like, horizontal plane you are. Because, like, sometimes it does that whole, like, charge-up thing, and then other times it fucking just charges right away. Although, interestingly, it doesn't seem to do anything when it's not charging, like it doesn't hurt you. No! God! Ah, oh, this fucking thing. I hate this monster so much. Jerk. I'm leaving. Okay. So I need to do this, throw Theo, and then do that. That's fine. We have to be close. Well, if Theo can feel it, then we definitely are close. Okay, never mind. That was definitely just random contact damage on the monster's ass. Chapter complete. (laughs) 28 out of 31 with another 83 deaths. And B-side. Neato.